etching, and today we're going to make a quill pen out of a primary flight feather from a goose. To make the quill pen, what we want to do is we want to take our goose feather and we're going to want to scale off, take off the scaly material with our thumbnail for the whole length of the shape. Then you're going to want to actually lop off the tip about there. So you just want to make a nice slicing cut, and then you'll wind up with this, and then you want to use this tool that actually has a hook at the end, just a wire with a bent end, to put inside the shaft and then turn around and take out the cellular material that's located in the pen, so it's all just void inside there. We want to submerge the quill in the hot sands, which is from the beach, and it's nice fine sand, and it's actually very hot to the touch. It's on the burner, and so it's what we're going to do is we are going to take the pen, that's the shaft, fill it with the hot sand to the top, and then we're going to actually submerge it in the hot sand. Okay, 5 minutes later, the quill should be pretty much cooked, so I'm going to actually just take it out of the hot sand and dump the sand out. I just took this quill out of the hot sand. The reason why I put it in the hot sand is so that it can become more brittle and the oils in it can be burned off somewhat. So it'll be much more useful as a drawing instrument because it will not flex as much. And as you can see, it's slightly yellow and much more cloudy, and it makes a different sound than one that just has not been cooked, like this one. This one is much more clear, and you can tell it makes a duller sound because it still has lots of oils. Now I'm going to do the center cut. All I'm going to do is I'm going to bring the knife down to the middle, and I'm going to draw straight back. There you go. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is do two side cuts to meet more or less at the center cut, and those two side cuts are just going to be scooping out material, making the tip more of a real tip, and they're going to be more or less concave as well. Okay, now that I've done those two scooping cuts, the tip is uneven, so I need to do a like perpendicular cut, and I need a backboard for that. So now I want to do that perpendicular cut, and I'm just going to come down straight across. There we go. Alright, so I just wanted to show you what the quill tips look like when they're more or less finished, and that's what the tips look like. See how they're kind of concave and they have the center cut. Now we're going to make the brass reservoir, and you can just make the brass reservoir from this brass sheet that you can buy. And okay, let's cut a strip of the sheet brass with my metal snips. I like to use sandpaper to kind of deburr the edges because they're pretty sharp. And then once I've done that, I'll just take the metal strip and I will just basically start making the curve, forming the brass reservoir with the little needle nose pliers. So this one already has a curve, and then I'll just kind of do the reverse curve at the end by turning and then moving up, turning, moving up, turning, moving up, very carefully using the tip so it becomes a nice circle, and then I'll trim off the excess. So this one looks like it needs to be straightened too, so I'll just kind of straighten it, make sure it's straight there, and then I'm going to trim off the excess over here at the end. Okay, right there. And then I can just continue forming that so it's a nice tight circle. Here we're just kind of flattening it. And it's a difficult thing to do, to flatten it down against the width. But that's what I want to do down in this rounded section that's going to actually go into the pen. So when I pull it out, it's not going to deform and just kind of unwind itself. When you finish making the brass reservoir, make sure that the tip is pretty pointy so it'll fit right on that slot. And I've hammered this part flat so that it will not deform as easily when I insert it and take it out of the shaft. When you use your pen, you're going to just take the brass reservoir and you're just going to insert it into the pen, and the tip of the brass reservoir should be right on that center groove, and not too much pressure, just kind of sitting on the center groove just like that, and about like 1 or 2 millimeters back from the tip of the pen. I'm going to actually put a couple of drops of ink onto my pen. 1, 2 is about right. I can use the side of the pen just in a cross stroke to get nice thin lines, and I can use just the broad side of the pen to get thicker lines. So there's a lot of variety. And I've just filled the pen with ink now, so that's why I'm getting some nice dark lines. But towards the end of the ink supply, I'm going to get lighter lines, lines that are going to be more kind of dry marks, and they're going to be actually pretty different. So there's a large variety of marks I can get with the quill pen. Like now it's starting to be dry. At the end of the drawing session, I like to clean the quill pen with a few streams of water from a water bottle, and then I take the brass reservoir out so that it won't distort the pen overnight. And I'll just store it right here on my little tape that I've wound around it to make it a bigger diameter so it's more comfortable. I hope you enjoyed making the quill pen with me. And the quill pen, as you use it, the tip of it will change, it'll kind of wear down. You might have to resharpen it slightly, not much, maybe even do another center cut. And you might have to adapt using it to the rounded tip. But you can still use it and have a lot of enjoyment from it. Probably it'll last for something like 2 or 3 months, maybe even more, 6 months to a year, the same quill. I've wrapped tape around mine so it's a little wider and easier to use. And I like to store it in a case like this so that it's protected.